One good thing to carry with you is one of these. This is a Bible I carry in my back pocket. Sometimes I forget. Actually, it's a New Testament, and it's always good to have one on you. In today's second reading, we can look at what the Bible says from 1 Corinthians 9, and we're going to look at part 22 to 24, which is the latter part of today's second reading. And what we're looking at is something important for those of us who want to understand Paul in light of our Catholicism. And it's simply this. This is Paul's vision of what it means to live the faith. See, Paul is making it clear, do whatever it takes to spread the faith. Do it. Do sacrifice. Sacrifice your wants for the sake of the gospel. Sometimes maybe sacrifice your needs for the sake of the gospel. Do whatever it takes. So we look at chapter 9, verse 22 of 1 Corinthians. To the weak I became weak to win over the weak. I have become all things to all to save at least some. All this I do for the sake of the gospel so that I too may have a share in it. That's Paul's vision. Do whatever you can. See, a lot of times we deal with situations where people will use the gospel for their own advancement. They'll use the gospel so that they can, you know, become rich, or they'll use the gospel so that they can, you know, become famous, or whatever the case may be. None of that works, and that always is building a house of cards. Because one of the things that'll happen in those cases is people will not sacrifice for the greater good of spreading the gospel. What Paul is saying is, I will sacrifice what is necessary for the greater good of spreading the gospel. And that's the important element of living our Catholic faith. One of the things that we're dealing with in our culture is that whole thing is, I have to do what's best for me. And that came very strongly during the me decade of the 1970s. But in fact, that's not Catholic teaching. I have to do what's best for the gospel. I have to do what's best for the church. I have to do what's best for our mission of spreading the gospel. And that means giving of yourself. That means taking chances. That means being on the forefront in such a way that the message of the gospel is preached. Your choice always is, am I going to follow Jesus? And if I'm going to follow Jesus, I'm going to end up on a cross. I'm going to get myself in trouble. There's always a risk of getting in trouble if you are living the gospel. But the other side of the fence is that if I need to follow the gospel in a way that benefits me, it's going to collapse because you're not going to go that extra mile. You're only going to go so far. And when you're challenged to go the extra mile, you're going to stop. And what gospel you're living at that point is going to betray you. This is what Paul understood. And it wasn't that he lived in a fear of reaching that position. He lived with a passion of spreading the gospel. When we choose to live our Catholic faith, we need to wake up in the morning and say, what am I going to do to spread the gospel? And when we are challenged, the question we need to ask ourselves is, what is the route that is best? Sometimes it's the safer route, but sometimes it's not. God bless you.